Hello everyone, today I'll discuss about still life painting ideas, techniques and tips. Step 2. In my last video already I discussed about some pictorial qualities and techniques of still life painting. Today I'll add some more qualities. Decide what to paint. One of the best ways to start the still life painting is to find some objects that really intrigue you. If you love the objects, you are more likely to be patient with the process of observing, examining and painting it. Think about the story you want to tell. Is it about color and texture, history or emotion, logistics and where to set up? Still life does not depend on whether like landscape painting or on hiring a model like figurative painting. Still life can be tackled almost anywhere there is lighting, a surface and objects. However, controlling light and determining your horizon or sight line are important from the beginning. What's the best subject to paint? When choosing a subject to paint, avoid setting yourself up for disappointment. Choose a subject and medium that you feel comfortable with, object that you feel you can handle. Something you love, whether it is dusty old books, utensils, study materials, dresses and shoes or juicy fruits and so on. If you love it and find the forms interesting, you will do it better. Because the most important single elements of a successful still life is patience. Patience to work until it's well and truly done. Selection of objects. Finally, this is the pure fun part. Gather some objects that's more or less related to the story you want to tell. Play with them. Use your imagination. Take your time. Move things around. It's a working process. Every step will take you closer to the final selection. Be patient and empathetic. Evolve with the process. Your first chosen object may be or may have to be abandoned. This can be a slow process, so take pictures to help. Photos also will provide 2D preview, which will be helpful to understand the composition. Setting up lighting. A consistent light source is needed to render forms with different value ranges. Any secondary or ambient light will create confusing shadows or reflections, making it difficult to understand what's really going on. If needed, set up blockers to prevent ambient light from casting confusion. Horizon. With still life, the horizon is not the point where the earth meets the sky. Rather, it's the sight line of the artist and viewer. When objects are placed on a table, we decide how much of the surface will be visible and that can influence the story. Viewing from above can be emphasize the space between the objects. Viewed straight on, similarities or contrast between the objects may be more significant. Atmosphere. What's the mood you want to set for your still life painting? Low-key paintings are predominantly dark and likely to create a somber mood or sense of strength and richness. High-key paintings are light, which can evoke a cheerier emotional response or a feeling of innocence. Think about this impact when making choices, especially for background. Visual hierarchy, focal point. A strong focal point draws the viewers in and start the conversation. Your focal point can be a single object or a dramatic reflection or other interplay between objects. In choosing subjects, consider the aspect of the elements you want to draw attention to. Visual hierarchy. Visual hierarchy refers to the arrangement or presentation of elements in a way what implies importance. In other words, visual hierarchy influences the order in which the human eyes perceives what it sees. This order is created by the visual contrast between forms in a composition. How can the artist create contrast? Objects with the highest contrast to their surroundings are recognized first by the human mind. Viewfinder. Use a viewfinder or your hands to help you focus on the images you want to include in your drawings. This helps to block out the surroundings area and really focus on the items you are looking at. Sighting. To sight means to measure. It is often referred to as sighting. This is another tool that artists use to get accurate drawings. To draw well, students need to learn to see size relationships, angle relationships, and the relationships of different negative space sizes. Students learn to measure and compare lengths, proportions, angles, and so on by sighting, by holding a pencil at arm's length while making composition observations. These measurements are transferred to the paper. Perspective, eye level, and foreshortening. The art of representing three-dimensional objects on two-dimensional surface so as to give the right impression of their height, width, depth, and position in relation to each other. Eye level is the actual height of the viewer's eyes when looking at an object. Foreshortening is a technique for creating the appearance that the object you are drawing is extending into space. This is done by shortening the lines with which the object is drawn. Thumbnail sketch. A thumbnail sketch is a quick drawing that explores the structure and value of composition. To create a thumbnail of your setup, look at it through a viewfinder. Note how the objects relate to one another and how the setup might be cropped. On a sheet of white paper, draw the contours of the objects inside a 4 by 5 inches rectangle. Then render this sketch in just three values: light, medium, and dark. Value range. After you are done with the thumbnail sketches, now level the highlight, shadow, cast shadow, and reflected light. Hope this entire discussion will be helpful for your working process. Now it's your turn to gather object that reminds you of a story or strong emotion. Spend time with them and explore possibilities and put together to create memorable still life painting. Gradually, I will also explain some more techniques and pictorial qualities of still life painting, which will be covered in my upcoming videos. That's all for today. Thank you.